Hi everyone, this is Pradeesh Nair from Bangalore and I just thought of creating some educational videos to help out our dear 10th standard young students in this unfortunate COVID season. So welcome to my small lecture on the first lesson and the first topic of the 10th standard biology, that is sensation and response. So what is basically a sensation, what is basically a response? All of us know the literal meaning of that. Let us see the biology behind the sensation and response. So before going to that, let me have a small picture which is given in your textbook. So this is a familiar scenario which all of us might have experienced or you are experiencing it now, especially when we go to villages, we all might have enjoyed this particular scenario. So there are so many actions and reactions which are going on in this picture if you carefully observe it. Okay, let us see what exactly happens in this. You see that a girl, right? This girl is eating mango and she seems to be very happy. Yes, see her face, she is very happy. So when she is eating mango, something made her happy, right? Some reactions which are going on in her body, that's why she seems to be very happy. Instead of having mango, if somebody comes and beats her, she will not be like this. She will start crying. A different reaction will be. But instead, you can see that this girl is having mango and she is very happy. Another girl, you see, she has taken little water from the stream. She is putting it into her face and she is enjoying it. She is relishing that particular moment. Okay, so one more action which is going on here. A boy and girl, a small boy and small girl, they have taken a small tin box and they are hitting into the tin box and he is enjoying it. What he is enjoying, you see here. What exactly he is enjoying? Some parrots were there in the field. That parrots are flew away. Because of this sound, the parrots got scared and it is flying away from there. One more small boy, you see, what is he doing? He is trying to touch a snail. What this snail is trying to do, it is withdrawing its body into its shell. Hope all of you might have seen a snail. The snail will be having a shell, right? It is a protection area for the snail, right? It contains a body. So whenever a scary situation, whenever a situation which the snail doesn't like or it feels that it is dangerous, this body will be withdrawn inside the shell. So that's what which is going on here. Okay, so there are so many actions and reactions which are going on in this particular picture when you see this. Okay, right. So why these children are very happy? Why that girl is very happy after having mango? And why this parrot flew away from there? There are some reaction, biological reactions which are going on in the system of the body, in the system of each and every living system. Right. So because of that only, it is showing some sort of reactions. Okay, so what exactly that reactions if we want to see, we want to understand a very important terminology called stimuli. Okay, the boy took a tin, right, paata kottiyappol aa thattakal parannu poi. So some sound which has come from the tin box, that made this parrots to fly away. Okay, so what is the reason for that parrots to fly away? There some sound came. From outside some sound came, the parrots got scared and the parrots flew away from that particular area. So whatever the reason for a particular reaction, so what is our topic, what exactly we are going to deal about? Sensation and response. So sensation is nothing but the sound which is created by the boy by using that tin box. And the response is nothing but what? The parrots got scared and it flew away from that particular region. Okay? So the reason for a particular response is that sound. That sound can be termed as a stimuli. So here, sound acts as a stimuli. So what exactly is a stimuli? So it is nothing but the senses. What was the senses? That is the parrot got scared and it flew away. That is the sense which the parrot got. Okay, so I will talk about senses later. First you understand what is the meaning of a stimuli. That is the senses that evoke responses in an organism. The senses which creates responses in an organism is called what? Stimuli. For example, I will tell you one more example. There is an iron box. The iron box is very hot. A person is going and touching to that particular iron box. Suddenly what that person will do? He will keep the hand like that and stand. His hand will be burned completely. So what he will do? Immediately he will withdraw his hand from that iron box. Okay, so he has done a response. What is the response? He withdrawn his hands from the iron box And what is the reason for withdrawing that? There was a stimuli. There was a high temperature in the iron box. Because of that only he has withdrawn. So that heat can be termed as what? Stimuli. And withdrawing of the hand can be termed as what? A response. So that's what clearly mentioned over here. The senses that evoke, that produces, the senses that produces a particular response in an organism are called what? Stimuli. Okay? So you can just visualize like this. An iron box you visualize, right? You switched on it for a long time. It got heated up. A person comes and touches it unknowingly. Immediately he withdraws his hand from there. Right? So there was a stimuli to withdraw the hand. The stimuli is nothing but what? The heat which is generated from the iron box, and the response is nothing but what? Removing the hand. So there is a stimuli for a response. This is what I wanted to mention. For every response, there will be a stimuli. If the stimuli is there will be a response. Okay? So what is the stimuli? I just told you now. It is the sense. I have to withdraw my hand. That is a sense that produced. Okay, that is the response which is produced due to what? The stimuli. Okay, so the senses that evoke response in an organism is called what? A stimuli. Okay, right. So that is called stimuli which is coming from outside. You came inside the house, you touched the iron box and you got a response. Right, so that is nothing but the stimuli can be termed as, or it can be classified as, external stimuli and internal stimuli. Whatever happens, which happens from outside our body can be termed as external stimuli. What is happening within the body, the stimuli which happens within the body can be termed as what? Internal stimuli. Okay, hope you are clear with the external stimuli. See, one person was beating with what? A tin box. The parrots flew away. So the parrot got an external stimuli. That sound has come. So it is an external stimuli. Okay, internal stimuli. We will be having within our body itself, we will be having some stimuli. So that is called what? Internal stimuli. So what are the examples of internal stimuli? Right? So when we are taking food, after taking food, the food got digested completely and you got energy. That energy is used up. Again, you want energy. For that, you require what? Food. So how your body knows that energy is completely lost, you want to have food. We have a stimuli called hunger in our body. Okay, we will be having a stimuli hunger, right? So when we feel hunger, right, what we will do? We will take food and we will have food. It is a stimuli which is created from the body itself. It gives an indication to your body that you have to do this. You have to have food. So that is an example of what? Internal stimuli. Right? And one more example for the internal stimuli, that is thirst. Our body is completely dehydrated. We went and played so much of cricket in the ground, came back, our body is completely dehydrated. Immediately we will feel thirsty and we will have lot of water. It is the stimuli which your body gives to you that your body is out of water, you have to have water. Okay, so this is another example for what? Internal stimuli. One more example which is not mentioned here, even though I will tell you, if your body is completely diseased, your body is having some damage, the body parts is having some damage, then how your body will tell you that some part of the body is damaged? You will have a stimuli called pain. If you see, the pain is the biggest gift of God. If we don't have pain, we won't be knowing what is happening in our body. A kidney failure, the kidney damage, there is a pain in the abdominal region will tell that something happened in the abdominal region. You will go to a doctor, the doctor will check that and the doctor will tell you that the kidney is having some problem. So these type of things are called what? Stimuli. So to concise that, I will tell you there are two types of stimuli which creates, I mean stimuli means what? The compound which, or the reaction which creates a response is called stimuli. That's what we have seen. So the stimuli can be classified into two: external stimuli and internal stimuli. External stimuli, we have seen that the sound, the light, you are going in, you are getting up in the morning, the completely it is dark, it's an early morning, immediately you are taking your mobile and switching on the mobile, suddenly a light comes, your eyes cannot tolerate that, you will just close the eyes or you will reduce the brightness of your mobile. External stimuli, the light which is coming. Right, the sound which created by that boy, because of that the parrot got scared and ran away. That is an external stimuli. The heat which is created from iron box, the heat which is created from the iron box, that is an external stimuli. My energy is completely lost. I want to have food. The stimuli which created by our body is nothing but hunger. Body is completely dehydrated. I mean there is no water in the body. the body will give you an indication that thirst, okay, another stimuli. I told one more example, that is pain also, okay. So how we will be having the stimuli should come to our body and we have to respond it. There should be some mechanism between stimuli and response, right? I touched the iron box, immediately I responded by withdrawing my hand from the iron box, right? So there is some reaction, there is a time interval between the stimuli and the response. There is a small fraction of time, yes? So some mechanism, some biological reactions are going on in between what the stimuli and the response, okay? So this is happening mainly because of the components called receptors present in our body. Okay, there are some components which are present in our body called receptors. These receptors only will be taking up the stimuli and it will create a response. How it will create a response, we will see. So the next terminology which you have to be very thorough with is, it is nothing but what? The receptors. Okay, so the receptors which are present in our body, it will receive the stimuli, okay, and it will create the response. How it will create the response? We are having sense organs, okay, in our body we will be having sense organs. So these sense organs are the region which contains receptors. What do you mean by receptors? Receiving, okay, the another terminology, receiving. We are receiving the stimuli. So the receiving components which are present in our body is called what? Receptors. Okay, so where the next question is, where the receptors are present? Receptors are present all over the body, especially in 5 different organs in our body, that is called your sense organs. Okay, so the 5 different organs which has a receptor which is having the capacity to receive the stimuli is called what? Sense organs. So all of you know, in Malayalam we used to tell that panjendriyangal, 5 different organs. Okay, so what are all the 5 different organs which contains receptors? In the textbook, here it has given 2 examples of 2 different sense organs which contains receptors. Okay, so you can see the tongue and the eye. See, you just take a little sugar and put it in your tongue, you are very happy. Okay, because the receptors which are present in the tongue, which will understand the taste, means it will take up the signal and it will give to brain and tell, what is this? Yes, it is a sugar, it is good. Yes, you have it, you are very happy. Instead of that, you put little chili powder, immediately your brain will tell that is, receptors will take that stimuli and give it to brain, and the brain will tell that it is very not good for you. It will burn your tongue. Okay, so the only thing which I wanted to make clear here is nothing but there are different sense organs which are present in our body. So these sense organs contains specific areas. These areas are called what? Receptors. So what is receptor? These are all the areas which receives the stimuli. Okay, the receptors are nothing but the areas which receives the stimuli. Okay, so these receptors are present in the sense organs. 2 different sense organs are given over here. One is the tongue, another one is the eye. So if you see totally, there are 5 different sense organs are present. So what are the 5 different sense organs? One is eyes, the second one is nose, the third one is ear, the next one is skin, the next one is tongue. Okay, so these are the 5 different receptors, 5 different sense organs which are present. So these sense organs will be containing receptors, means nothing but the areas which can receive the stimuli. So once the, see for example, you just take the example of tongue only. Once the tongue, you are putting little sugar, the receptors of the tongue will take up that stimuli. It is chemical stimuli, yes. Sugar is a chemical, right? So that chemical stimuli. See, if a light is coming and you are closing your eyes, it is nothing but a physical stimuli. This is nothing but a chemical stimuli. So that sugar, that chemical stimuli, nothing but the sugar, is tasted by the receptors of the tongue, and this will take up the signal. Okay, so whatever the chemical signal, it is nothing but the sugar, that chemical signal which will be taken, and it creates impulses. So now I told you that there is a time lapse between touching the iron box and withdrawing your hand. So in between, what is happening? That's what we are discussing here. Okay, so with respect to a simple example, that you are putting little sugar into the tongue. So when you put the sugar into the tongue, what happened? The receptors have taken that, okay, that stimuli, that is sugar, is taken, right? So you got the signal. So the receptors got the signal. So once the receptor gets the signal, it will create an electrical impulse or impulse. So how it will transfer is, it will create impulse. Okay. Before going to that, I will just tell you. So the most important part for taking a decision in our body is, all of you know that it is nothing but brain. Okay. If a dog is coming to bite you, what you will do? You will run. So who will decide whether to run or fight with the dog? It is nothing but the brain. So we have a system to respond to a particular stimuli. That is called what? Central nervous system. Okay, in our body there is a system which is responsible for all type of actions. Is nothing but the central nervous system. We will see what is that central nervous system first before going to what exactly happens in the response. So this is what the central nervous system. This is the central nervous system. So there will be nerves. Okay, so you can see nerves, which is nothing but the electrical connection, whatever in the household wiring which we will be doing, no? So to transfer the signals or transfer the light, or we will be having electrical wiring system. Same way in our body, we will be having nerves. And the next important component of your central nervous system is nothing but spinal cord. And the next important thing is nothing but the brain. Okay, so these are the three important components of the central nervous system: brain, spinal cord, and nerves. Okay, so now we will discuss. See, I am touching into a hot iron box, and I have to decide that I have to withdraw my hand. So who is giving direction to me? It is nothing but the brain or the spinal cord. Okay, in case of reflex action, it is spinal cord. Don't confuse now. Okay, so you just think it as it is a brain. So when I touch it, that electrical impulse, that heat energy is taken by the receptors of my skin. I told you there are 5 sense organs, right? Skin is also a sense organ. So the receptors will be present in the skin also. So the skin takes up that, and then it transfers into the spinal cord and the brain. And then the brain tells that, remove your hand immediately. The spinal cord tells that, remove your hand immediately. Otherwise you will be burned. So how it will tell? It will not call up you and tell. There will be some electrical signal or electrical impulses which will be transferring, that will tell you what has to be done. Okay, so we will see one example with respect to that. You are putting little sugar into the mouth, right? So when you put, what happened? You are enjoying that sugar. So how you are enjoying it? Or instead of that, you are putting little chili powder into your mouth. What will happen? You will not enjoy that situation. So both are chemicals, both are components. One is so sweet, another one is it cannot be tolerated. Okay, so how this mechanism works out? So you are putting the sugar, so your tongue receptors will take up that signal. Once it is taking the signal, it will be converted into impulses. Okay, receptors receive the signal will be converted into what? Impulses. Then through the nerves, it will be transferred into spinal cord and brain. Okay, through the nerves, I told you nerves are nothing but what? The electrical connections. Okay, it is nothing but a network which is present in your body. So it will transfer into the spinal cord and brain. So the spinal cord and brain will coordinate and decide that, okay, right, this is not good for you. So you take an action of spitting of that, or you take an action of swallowing of that. Okay, so this is what happens in case of a response. I'll repeat once again. So you are getting a stimuli. So the stimuli is taken by whom? The receptors. Receptors will convert that into what? A impulse. This impulse will be transferred it into spinal cord and brain. The spinal cord and brain will coordinate each other and creates a particular action. So this is what the mechanism of the response due to a particular stimuli. Okay, so who plays a very important role? The nerves plays a very important role here to transfer the signals. I told you, receptor, then you have signals, impulses, coordination with the spinal cord and the brain, and you are creating an action. Okay, so in this session, we will mainly discussing about the nervous system. So nerves are nothing but I told you it is just like an electrical connection wires in the household things. Okay, so the basic structural and functional unit of nerve is nothing but a neuron. Okay, the basic and structural and what do you mean structural and functional? It is made up of, the structure is made up of what? Neuron. And the neuron acts itself as what? The functional unit also. So what is neuron? The neurons are nothing but the structural and functional unit of nervous system. Okay, I'll repeat once again. The neurons are nothing but the basic structural and functional unit of the nervous system. Okay, so when I'm talking about a cell, in the lower classes you might have studied that the cell will be having a cell wall, then comes cell membrane, then comes cytoplasm, then comes nucleus. Major components, I'm telling you. There are so many other ancillary components which are present in the cytoplasm and cell wall, other things. So the major difference between the animal cell and plant cell is the plant cell has a cell wall, the animal cell doesn't have a cell wall. So the neurons, it is nothing but an animal component, therefore it does not contain a cell wall. So it contains a cell membrane followed by cytoplasm, next comes what? Nucleus. So the structure of neurons I am talking about. About neuron, I told only 2 points. The neurons are nothing but what? It is the basic structural and functional unit of the nervous system. Okay, so it is the functional unit. So this is the main active unit of what? The nervous system, that is a neuron. Now, if you see the structure of the neuron contains what? A cell membrane, then comes a cytoplasm, right? Cytoplasm is the liquid part of the cell which is present inside. Then the nucleic acid or nucleus, where genetic material, DNA, RNA, all those things you might have seen and you will be studying in the coming classes also. Okay, so what are all the components which is present in the neuron? It contains a cell membrane, it contains a cytoplasm, it contains a nucleus. Okay, right. So now we will see what is the structure of a neuron. How exactly the neuron looks like. You can see this yellow color diagram. This is the structure of what? The neuron. Okay, so starting from the extreme left, you can see that some branches which are present. Okay, some branches which are present here. Right. Like a tree branch, you can see. So this branch is nothing but your dendrites. Okay, it is called what? Dendrites. So the dendrites are made up of dendrons. The branches of dendrons are called what? Dendrons. So this particular branches, okay, so it is made up of dendrons, and this branches are called what? The branches of dendrons are called what? The dendrons. So the first part is nothing but the dendrons or dendrites. I'm talking about the structure of a neuron. The structure of neuron is nothing but what? The first part is nothing but your dendrites. What is dendrite? It is a branches of dendron. It is a chemical compound. It is a biological compound of the neuron. Okay. So what is the function of that dendrite? I told you that there are receptors, right? So which acts like a receptor? Which receives the impulses from adjacent neuron. Okay. Say lateral receptors is a different one. This is from the external sense organ, it is there. Okay, so here it partly acts as a receptor, or let us not confuse. There is a part that receives the impulses from adjacent neurons. I told you the basic structural and functional unit of the nervous system is nothing but neuron. It means that many neurons combine together to form what? The nervous system. One neuron, after that another neuron, another neuron. Like that, many neurons will be arranged. That is nothing but your nervous system. Okay. So when we discuss about the structure of a typical neuron, the first part which we have discussed is nothing but what? Dendrites. Okay, the branched region which you can see here is nothing but your dendrite. Okay, it is given in the arrow mark. You can see in the blue line, it is given branches of dendrons or dendrites. What is the function of the dendron? It receives the impulses from adjacent neuron. I told you so many neurons will be there in the nervous system. So from one neuron to another neuron, from the tongue, the sugar signal has to go to brain. So from one neuron, the signal will go to the next neuron, then it will go to another neuron, like that. It will continuously, the process will happen. So the dendrites are the region which will transfer the impulses from one neuron to another neuron. Okay, so that is nothing but dendrites. Okay, right. So I told you that there are dendrons which makes into dendrites. Right, so the filamentous part, you can see that this branched part is nothing but dendrite. I told you the filamentous part, stick like appearance, which you can see here in the blue line which is connected over here, you can see that it is nothing but the short filamental region of the cell body. Okay, we just discussed, no, the nerve cells will be having a cell, right? The cell is composed up of what? Cell membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. Okay, so the filamentous part of the cell body is called what? Dendron, right? So what is the function of dendrite? I told you that is it will transfer the signal from one neuron to another neuron. Then what is the function of the dendron? So this carries impulses from dendrites to cell body. From dendrite, the signal is connected into the cell body. So who is connecting that? Who is taking care of that reaction? It is nothing but dendrons. Okay, so don't confuse with dendrites and dendron. Dendrite is the external part, the branched part, right? Dendron is nothing but the filamentous part. So what is the function of dendrite? It transfers impulses from one neuron to another neuron. But what is the function of the dendron? It carries impulses from dendrites to the cell body. Okay, from the branch inside the cell, it will transfer. That is the function of what? The dendrites. Okay, next comes, see, if you see, there are a filamentous region, a long filamentous regions you can see. These are called axons. Okay, so the long filamentous region which you can see over here, yellow color which you are seeing over here, it is nothing but what? Axon. It is the filamentous, the longest filamentous part of the cell body. So you can see dendrites, then dendrons, then cell body, then comes axons. The long filamentous region is called what? Axon. Okay, so what is the function of the axon? It carries impulses from the cell body to outside. Dendrite took the impulse, right? Then the next compound, dendron, transfer that impulse into the cell body. Now within the cell body, the signal will be transferred through axons. Okay, so it will transfer outside the cell body through the axons. Okay, right. This is electrical signal. Actually, if you see, it is nothing but an electrical signal. So it should be completely controlled. An insulation should be there, right? Otherwise, electrical signal. See, you can see that the wire, a small cut which is present in the wire, right? We will put an insulation tap to avoid any type of shock or dispersion of the electricity. So for that, in the axon, within the axon, surrounding the axon, you will be having a cell called Schwann cells. We will talk about Schwann cells later. Okay, so the Schwann cells are there which encircles the axon, means it covers the axon. The cells which are covering the axon is called what? Schwann cells. It protects your axon, it gives oxygen, all those things are there. We will see that later. Now you understand that axons are there, the longest filamentous body, so which transfers the electrical impulses outside your cell body, means from one axon to one neuron to another, it is transferring. Okay, so there is a region wherein which it is protected. That protected region is called what? Nothing but the Schwann cells. Okay, then a long filamentous body, you can see again it is ending as a branch. That branches are called what? Axonite. Clear? So initially there was a branch. That branch is called what? Dendrite at the beginning. At the end also, after axon, after all the axon, you can see that some more branches. So that branches are called what? Axonite. Okay, so this will transfer impulses to the synaptic knob. What do you mean by synaptic knob? Means, I told you that many neurons are combined together to form your nervous system. One neuron, next neuron, next neuron. So between one neuron to another neuron, there will be a gap. Yes, there is a gap which is present, or there is a joint which is present between one neuron to another neuron. That joint is called what? Synapse. Okay, so that joint is called what? Synapse. So whatever the impulses are there, the impulses will be transferred into synapse by using this particular compound called axonite. Okay, it is called what? Axonite. Right? Next, you can see the last branch, tip of the branch, that is called synaptic knob. Okay, it is the tip of the axonite. Right? So it is called what? Synaptic knob. So what it will do is, see, the electrical signal is received by your dendrite, right? Then it is transferred to dendron, then it is transferred to the cell body, then it is transferred to axon. From the axon, it is transferred into axonite, then it is transferred it into where? Into the synaptic knob. So electrical signal should transfer from one neuron to another neuron. So during this transfer, what will happen is, this electrical signal will be converted into chemical signal. That chemical signal is called neurotransmitter. Okay, that chemical signal is called what? Neurotransmitter. It is very, very simple, don't complicate it. That is, electrical signal will be converted into some chemical. That chemical is called what? Neurotransmitter. Okay, so this chemical is taken by the next neuron. You just see there, again the cycle repeats. So the dendrite will take up that chemical, will be converted into an impulse, right? Then transferred into cell body. Again it goes to the axon, it reaches into the axonite. Again it will be converted into a chemical signal, transfer it into next axon. So this process continues. So this is the structure of a typical neuron. Okay, you can just rewind once again. So what is there in the left, in the beginning? That is a dendrite which receives your signal, right? So which receives the impulses from the adjacent neurons. Okay, the next comes dendrons. Whatever which is received by the dendron, which will be given to the dendron to give it to cell body. From the cell body, the signal will go to the axons. From the axon, the signal will go to axonite. From the axonite, the signal goes to the synaptic nerve, and this process continues. Again, it starts from first. Again, whatever it is given, it starts from dendrite, dendrons, axon, axonite, etc. Okay, so this is how the electrical signal which will be passed in the central nervous system or the nervous system. Okay, yeah, you can have a look of this diagram once again. Right, whatever branched in the extreme left is nothing but and dendrite. The filamentous part, small filamentous part, is nothing but dendron. And the star shaped component, which is nothing but your cell body. From the cell body, it is nothing but what? Axons. Axons are covered with a particular cell called what? Schwann cells. Then this axon end up as what? Axonite, as a branched axon. Okay, then the final component in the neuron is nothing but synaptic knob. Okay, I will explain this process, how exactly happens. A particular stimuli is coming, so dendrites will take up. This will be transferred into dendron. Dendron will transfer it into the cell body. Cell body will transfer it into axon. Axon will transfer into axonite. And finally, it reaches into the synaptic nerve. Where what will happen? The electrical signal converted into chemical signal, that is called neurotransmitter, and transfer into next neuron. So likewise as a chain reaction, it will go on and it will reach into the target site. What is the target site? How it reaches? All those things we can see in next class if you are interested. So once again I will tell you, this is Prajesh Nair from Bangalore, and my mobile number is 973978750 for any sort of this type of educational assistance. You can just contact me. I'll repeat once again, 973978750. Thank you so much for your patient hearing.